to the reassembling your 4AGE video on YouTube. Okay. Just a little Corolla updates. You got the 11 front fenders. These are just OEM fiberglass fenders. So I'm going 11 front end. It's gonna be cool. So I got my headlights and hood up for sale. So if you guys are interested in Terrano parts, hit me up, send me a message, send me a DM on Instagram, and I'll hook you guys up. The block, last time you guys saw, we were getting that thing all situated. Let's bump up the aperture a little bit. So I just sprayed the block with some black ceramic high heat paint, and it's looking pretty clean. It looks very nice. So tonight, I'm gonna be working on the head, putting all the seals in the head, putting the valve stem seals on, getting all the cam seals done, the VVT solenoid stuff, water pump, or not water pump, you know, the water piece that goes on the back of the head for the thermostat, all of that stuff. We're gonna put that together. And just talking about it, just hanging out, guys. We're just gonna be hanging out. You, me, the 4AGE. We're gonna be hanging out, enjoying our time tonight. In preparation for this, I actually put this head in the dishwasher. Okay? Now, it worked pretty well. It cleaned it up to a good degree here. You can see it's relatively shiny and back to somewhat of a nice finish. So that's a cool little quick tip that you guys may or may not want to know. Give it a shot or don't. But yeah, we're gonna be putting together a head. Gonna be having a fun time. You and me. It's gonna be great. So let's get into it. Hope you guys are liking the funky little cool intros to all the videos. They're fun to make. They make a little cool, little jazzy, kind of cool intro for y'all. So let's get started. All right, here we are. Square one. A bare, boring 12 valve head. If you want to call that boring. It's pretty exciting if you ask me. But we're starting with the valve stem seals. There are these little guys right here, just little cups with some rubber in them. It just helps kind of wipe the oil going up and down on the valve stems, keeps gunk in and keeps gunk out. So when I was taking these out, I was using these needle nose pliers. Just put some masking tape around the outside of them so I didn't gouge the surfaces that the bucket's right on. And then just hold down on them, pull them out. It's kind of temperamental, but it's not too bad. Putting them in is a lot easier. I'm just using these tweezers to kind of situate it on top. And then I'm using this long bolt here. I think it's a 12 mil, just 12 mil bolt. It's probably 2 inches long. Sticking it in there and just kind of pushing it in. I'm using this. I was going to use my thumb, but this is a lot easier just because it's like a nice flat surface and it'll just put it in. Nice. We're going to be putting in the valve stem seals, and I will see you guys in a very, very short time period right now. Got those bad boys in. Now it's time to put in the valves. I wanted to make a quick note that you want to put it in the same way they came out, just because each valve is seated to to its respective position. So before I took them out, I took a picture. I marked each one with a number and then took a picture so I know where each one goes. This is going to be 12. This is going to be 1. This is going to be 1, and this is going to be 8. Doesn't matter to you, but take a picture of your head before you take out your things. Otherwise, you're fucked. All right, guys, so I got about 75% of the valves put in, along with the springs and everything. So it's just pretty, it's been a long process, pretty tedious and things. I've just been using a 14 millimeter socket that I cut in half. So it kind of has like a window on one side, and then I just got it on a 3/8 extension. I put a rag in my hand, and then you just place the valve spring in there and the little cap and then the two collets that are there. I'll show you guys here in a minute. Yeah, then you just kind of got to finagle it, push down and let them just kind of slope in, and there's a little ridge that's on the intake valves, or all the valves, and there's like a respective like whoop-de-doo on the collets, and then that just kind of gets sucked in there. So before I start putting these in, I put a folded up rag or whatever underneath it on the other side in the combustion chamber to like help brace against the valve so that they don't compress downwards and open when I'm pushing down on this valve spring. Put your little cap on, then you got your two little collets inside. I get them pre kind of spaced out and things. And then I like to press it on first with my thumbs to get it started, and then we'll press it on the rest of the socket. So I'm gonna have to cover up your guys' view here for a second. Definitely takes a bunch of tries, and definitely takes a bunch of trial and error to figure out like your kind of technique here. I found like just pushing down and kind of wiggling it side to side and just making sure that the collets kind of follow downwards with it. And you've got to kind of like maybe shake it a little bit. You just have to be very precise with it. Like this one in the back kind of sticking. Yeah. So I just nudged it a little to kind of help follow it down. So there we go, we're at the proper height. Pull up, boom, she's on there. You just gotta push it down enough that the collet's little ridge in there like passes the notch that's in the valve stem. And then once you get it down in there, she's locked in there. You can kind of see that it's kind of spaced one way, like one side of the collet is touching and the other side's separated. And that's not supposed to be the case. It's supposed to be an even gap between the two. So what I did on the exhaust side, I pushed down a little bit on the side that was touching, and then I took my tweezers and then I just kind of separated the gap with it, and I just pushed down just enough that it would have like released just enough tension, not pop them out, just enough tension so I could just pop that thing in there and just kind of wiggle them apart and then come back. And then that's what's been working for me. So I got the head all together, all the valve springs are in there, so I'm ready to put the head onto the block. And I'm using ARP head studs, so before you can put the head studs in, we gotta chase all the threads here. I'm using just a M10 by 1.25 tap. Not exactly a thread chaser, but it'll work. It's fine just because these are already threaded, it'll work. Don't worry, guys. So I'm just putting this in just like I would a bolt, getting some threads engaged. And then take out my little ratchet here, we're just ratcheting them down. So it just says put them in hand tight at first after cleaning the threads and everything. And then it gives you a nice little fastener assembly lubricant. So I'm just putting a dab of this stuff on one of the threads. Make sure you're doing it on the side that doesn't have the Allen keyhole on it. And then I just take another one and I roll them together, and that's how it gets embedded in those two threads. So basically we're gonna dress all of these here and then hand tie them in and just keep on going. Okay guys, the head is on the block. It's time to start torquing down those nuts. So this is gonna be up to 70 foot-pounds, and which is a lot higher than what the Toyota head bolts go to. And then we're gonna be doing this in a three-stage process. So we're gonna be torquing it in Toyota sequence, which is like this. And then we're gonna go one pass, two pass, three pass. So on the first pass, I'm gonna take it up to 25 foot-pounds. Second pass, I'm gonna do 50. Third, I'm gonna do 70. Just kinda in thirds, close enough. So that's the idea there. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Keep watching. All right, I'm gonna keep trying to make some cool videos. I'm gonna get some good driving in. We're gonna get this thing going. It's gonna be great. So I'll see you guys next time. Toodaloo. Bye.